Good morning, Pastor Seko.
Good morning, Brother Francis.
I'm glad to be with you. I'm happy for your effort you have been doing in this place. So, as a pastor, could you please tell me how you got to know Jesus?
Thank you very much, my brother. I have been a Muslim all along. And one day I have an encounter with Jesus. In the beginning, I never believed in Jesus. In fact, I hate the name Jesus. I hate to hear Jesus' name. Even my colleagues who used to speak to me about Jesus, I hate them all. But one day they told me that you are going to become a Christian. I denied them completely. It comes to a time, my brothers, there was an evangelist from all the way from Brazil. They came along with Pastor Zachariah, who is all the way from Freetown. And God used that man, Zachariah. He spoke to me, and I was convinced. Then I reasoned it out. Then the vision came during the night. And I saw myself holding a torchlight, you know, pointing it during the night. And I also see myself working with missionaries. So I think the confirmation come. Then I just make up my mind that I should be a Christian.
Good. So since you accepted Jesus, could you please tell me some of the challenges you went through your friends or your family, relatives or your neighboring people? So what are some of the challenges since Christianity is not common in this place? Could you please tell me, sir?
Well, I think this is very serious. Becoming a Christian is easy to become a Christian. But to stay as a Christian is very difficult. That is what I learned. When I receive Christ, my life is free. But going through the challenges, this is where comes the problem. No sooner I accept Christ, my friends started going away from me. Good friends. Because they see me as a different person. Even the community people, what they used to tell me in their conversations, they are speaking with their mouth, but their heart is different. You know, even in terms of work, in the area of church work, I can see people going out, you know, going far away from me. You know, I was isolated. You know, once a time, a brother of mine come around and told my family that he saw me in a dream. My mother is trying to chase me to leave Christianity. Christianity should not be part. It's not a religion. You know, so if I did not leave Christianity, I will have a problem. So, but fortunately, I told my brother that it is well. You know, I accept Christ with my whole heart. So there is no reason that I can leave Christ. That is the work of the devils. So these challenges come. And there is another challenges, even in terms of when they are discussing their important issues, they eliminate me, so I see all these things, but thanks be to Jesus, because I'm overcoming.
Thank you. So, in some states or some countries, Muslims don't normally give their daughters to a Christian brother. So, I mean, did you face any challenge like that in this town?
Yes, in the area of selecting my beloved wife, it's another challenge, because each time I go, I look out for a wife. Now, I see some resistance, strong resistance. You know, people are using this as a means to convert me. And when I suspected that, I tried to divert my intentions. I asked the Lord to help me. You know, that happened once. It happens, you know, twice, even triple. Yeah. Even the last one, we go to the peak of the last minute, you know, wherein it is at a point now I should get access to the woman, you know. But it comes strongly that I am a Christian. You know, and I find out later the person was a very Muslim background, strong Muslim background. My hope was to break that gap, to break that barrier, to use that one to become a light in her family, just as I was for my family. But it doesn't work, you know. I was defeated because I was a Christian. Okay. So that is another challenge, you know, to have a wife, a Christian believing wife. But today I can say praise and thanks be to God because I have a Christian believing wife now. And that has surprised them, has surprised them. It's more beautiful than the ones that I have been looking out for. More beautiful than them, all of them. And more humble in spirit.
So now I'm coming to the church. As you can see, Apostolic Baptist Living Church, ABLC, right? So could you please tell me the origin of this church, how it came about in this particular town, Seria, Mongo Chiefdom?
Yeah, well, it was about 2011, just as I say, in the early, when the Brazilian came. There was a vision that was lay in the heart of one, our mom, our sister, which is Mama Graça. She's a Brazilian. It come deeply in her heart that she should come to the land of the Curanco to help them. And she tried to find out how can he get in connection with the Curanco. God was able to lead him in Sierra Leone. He told his boss at Brazil, Pastor Ebenezer, and due to that, they also tried to find a person in Sierra Leone that they can be connected. Unfortunately, there is a man named Zachariah, is a Limba, that is my own boss now, whom God used, you know, to have an encounter with Jesus. And Zachariah was a man that can also speak their language, the Portuguese language. So the two come, these people comes together and they come here to him. They come on outreach and I was evangelized and the Spirit of the Lord. I was able to receive the Spirit of the Lord. And that is how comes this Apostolic Baptism Living Church, through their effort, through the vision of that mom, Mama Graça. And she take the step. She's an old mom, but she have the heart of God. That is how it comes. And when they come, three of us were taken to go for training at Freetown's. Out of the three, only me was able to stand the trial. The two has abandoned. Even the other one I was working with has also abandoned. You know, but God is working mysteriously. It's working mysteriously because some of these people are going ashamed now.
So, since this church was founded, that was 2011, right? Mm. This church was found in Seria town. Mm. Since then to now, did Mrs. Mommy Grass has been coming to this place?
Yeah, well, after that time, she come twice. The first one, she come after their first visit. They come. She come alongside with Pastor Zachariah. They try to see the people that can go for the training. That was not too far from their first visit. You know. Then after that, we were able to take the step and go for the training. And after the training, she come back again to see the church. You know, with other people, they even baptize other people. They come by them. They are seven in numbers. They came in seven in numbers. So they were able to visit the church, and we are able to discuss a lot of issues. But since then, none of them has attempted, and that happened 2012. Since 2012, only Pastor Zachariah has come once. Since then, well, with the grace of the Lord, they have been managing up.
So since then, they have stopped coming. Before they stopped coming, did you receive any help from them financially?
No. Well, When we are starting the church, they told us that they will be giving us stipend to encourage us, not salary, but a stipend. And that started 1 month, 2 months. I think maximum 3 months it cut off. And those of my colleagues, they leave. They find out that there is no things in this church. You know, there is no better things. So they abandon the church. But with the grace of the Lord, I was able to stand strong. Because I didn't look at the money. I look at the faith I have received, the spirit that I have received.
So looking, looking at your faith and your commitment, I have been seeing in you since I came to this village. Did you feel that you are called by God or you call yourself to ministry?
Oh, that is perfectly true. Because the last time I was about to decide my mind, because all my colleagues have abandoned me. Even the village again, people are not loving me, people are isolating me, you know, not calling me in an important issue. I thought that this thing, maybe the God I'm serving is not a helping God. I tried to decide my mind when I go to Kabbalah that in my return back again, I will prepare to go down to Freetown so that I abandon the village. And the Spirit of God was able to reveal himself to me. Jesus was able to reveal himself to me. Then there came a revelation, you know, in the book of Ezekiel chapter 2 to chapter 3. You know, it comes strongly to me in dream to read it. It comes strongly. I refuse it. It comes again. I refuse 3 times. You know, together with Galatians chapter 2 verse 19 to 20. Mm-hmm. These are the chapters that come. Ezekiel chapter 2 and chapter 3 and Galatians chapter 2 verse 19 to 20. When I woke up, I tried to be frightened, try to figure out. I even forgot the scriptures, but it reminds me again. These are the scriptures. Then I go, I take the Bible, I try to read. I say, why? God is talking to Ezekiel that he should go and preach to the people. He should go. No matter the condition, no matter the situation, no matter the resistance, no matter their wickedness, he should go. So with this, I said, oh, I want to go down to Freetown. But I believe I should not go there again. This is a revelation. And I should go back to my village to go and help. And this is how I come about again to my village. Otherwise, I should have gone far. I should have been in Freetown or other places. But with this revelation, Ezekiel chapter 2 and chapter 3, it convinced me. Because I find out that the people are very stubborn. They have a stubborn spirit, you know. Marginalization, antichrist spirit is existing. You know. But when I find out, when the Lord speak to me, no matter how things are difficult, no matter the attitude of the people, let me go, then I have taken the venture.
Good. So now coming to the church beliefs or the church doctrine, what are your beliefs? Could you please tell me, sir?
Well, everything about Christ, according to the Bible, the New Testament, we believe. We believe everything according to the Bibles. Everything that is embedded in the Bible, we believe in it. We believe in the Old Testament. We believe in the New Testament. But we don't believe by living by law. We don't believe in that. Because I believe that with a tingle of an eye, someone can break the law. And breaking one law meaning that you have break the whole entire law. Because Adam and Eve break only one law. They break only one law. And they were able to be punished by God. So how many laws are we breaking today? If I imagine, I say, Lord, if we are living by law, then Adam and Eve should not be punished. They should have not been punished. Because they only break one law. They observe all the other things according to the Bible. But they break only the fruit of life. So if that is the case, the last time when they told me that we should live by law, when I was a Muslim, I tried all my best to live by law. But I was able to, with all that again, I'm falling back again. So I find out that living by the Lord is not. But when that is what I say in Galatians 2:20. You know, live by Jesus. Let Jesus be in you and you in Jesus. then that is the only help. But this is one of the strong things that reminds me that let me not think that let me live by myself or by my power or by my strength. Only with Jesus that I can able to survive.
Okay. So now, another thing again concerning this doctrine about dress code. I mean, tell us what you believe about dress code.
Well, we accept all dress code. We accept all the type of dressing in the church. Except the one that is exposing your nakedness. You know, exposing some parts that is not of God. You know, so we don't accept those dresses. Well, hence you dress modestly. You come to the church. You are allowed to worship. The Bible says it's not the clothes you wear. You know, it's not the food you eat. Not the food you eat, you know. But that spirit that is in you, that spirit that is in you, the heart of man is what carry him. The heart of man is what carry him. You know, if your heart is good, everything you do is good.
So, as a pastor, do you believe prophecy?
I believe prophecy.
Do you believe speaking tongues in the church?
I believe in speaking tongues because even myself, in the early stage, I hate people who speak in tongues.
But now
myself is speaking in tongues.
Good. Do you also believe laying hands on the sick people?
Yeah, recently it happens. Recently, I was laying hands on people.
Do you believe?
I was even reading the Bible this morning. Who telling me that he was laying hands on people? Yeah.
Do you believe Jesus as Lord over all?
Well, Jesus, I believe Jesus. In fact, I believe the Trinity. The Trinity. You see, I believe the Trinity.
Do you believe that Jesus was God who manifested according to Timothy, I think 1 Timothy 3:16, that God manifested in the flesh?
Yes. Did that come all about the Trinity?
God.
Yeah, because Jesus exists as a Father. It exists as a Son. It is existing today as a Spirit. So this is what, that is my confirmation, that it exists in all the forms. It exists in all the forms.
So do you believe that without Jesus, it is impossible for man to be saved?
Yes. That is quite so. Because when I read the character of Jesus, the character, the time, his time in the world, you know, he lived a godly life. Godly characters. Everything she does is a godly character. So that is another proof. There is a proof that without Jesus, there will be no sin. And the essence of her coming is made known. You know, it's to save people from their sin. Who can save us from your sin? So he's there to save us.
Do you believe that our holiness comes from God?
Yeah, of course.
Well, not by our doing?
Not by our strength. Our holiness is not by our strength. Our righteousness is not by our strength, not by our power. You know.
So do you also believe the resurrection and the life? The resurrection and
yes.
the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ?
It was said by Jesus and it has come to pass. So if Jesus was resurrected, then he gave us the promise that whatever I'm telling you now shall come to pass. The word of Jesus is not a word that is failing. God is not a liar. Jesus is not a liar. He said it and it happens. He resurrects. Everything he tells his disciples, it happened in the Bible. It happens. So believe in the resurrection.
Good. So do you believe also holiness in the church is good for every Christian?
Yeah, of course, because the Bible tells us without holiness, no one will go to heaven or never see the face of God without holiness. You cannot see the face of God. So it is good to be holy through the power of Jesus.
Good. So thank you very much, Pastor Seko. Now we have finished with the church doctrine. Now we are now coming to the present constraints or the trials, difficulties we are going through. I know, I personally know how you feel in this place, because this is a place wherein most pastors don't like coming. It is full of evil and full of hardship. To live here is a grace of God. It's not really easy. Now tell us some of your constraints and what can be done for you presently.
Yeah. Well, the constraint is so much. I'm a teacher. I've been teaching for 7 years without salary. That is a constraint. That is the teacher aspect, you know. But thank God I have been trained. I'm waiting for my results. You know, even where I'm teaching, we are teaching as a community teachers. You know, with the hope that if something is realized in here, I can use this fund to help the church, you know, without other help. You know. But now in the church, the constraint to have somebody who can step, even when I'm not here, to step in the gap, to have strong somebody, this is another challenge, it's another serious challenge. If I leave the church today, it will be very difficult for someone to step in my capacity, you know, to take the challenge. That is a challenge. And I may need a help there to train people. You know, even though we are trying it now, we have started it because I was not here before. It has taken me 2 to 3 years. I'm not in Seria. I just come on Friday and Saturday and go back Sunday after service. But now I have base. So I'm trying to bring some mechanism, you know, to implement Bible study so that people may grow in spirit. So I may need reinforcement in the area of Bible study. So when these people receive that spirit, when they learn from themselves, you know, it can go a longer way with them. They can't leave. You know. So that is one challenge, you know. Then in the church, even the pulpit, yeah, I don't have pulpit in the church. The chairs we are using is from the schools. You know, but thanks be to God because we are using them now. We are using them now. And there is a problem. I didn't go to Bible college. Another Bible, I didn't study. All I do discipleship training. Mm-hmm. That is DTS with YWAM, Youth with a Mission at Waterloo. That is, it goes for 5 months. We do four months, 3 months, theory, everything about the discipleship. Then we do 2 months practical. That is the teaching I have. So, I mean, I need to have more knowledge in going about, because this has been one of my greatest challenges. I don't know how to go about church issues. You know, my knowledge about church issues is very little. So because of this, when I go for my course at Kabbalah, I try to fellowship with different churches. And that gives me, I learn from them. I learn from some great men of God, like Jongshin Suleiman, and other films, you know, that I used to watch. This helped me to build my faith. And when I come this time around, I see things are happening. Miracles are happening. And the church is moving. People are giving their life. I believe if I go more, if I learn more powerful things will happen.
So, would you like to work with any other Bible-believing church?
I like to work with any Bible-believing church. In fact, the church is a para-church. It's a para-church. So we work with all churches. Yeah. The only thing this time around, my boss is asking to go under one church. So we have selected MCA, which they have not, up to now, they have not fully taken over. But the promise has been laid. You know. But we work with all churches, all Bible-believing churches. We work with them.
So that means that you can even work with Calvary Bible Believing Church, Calvary Chapel, Redeemed Christian Church of God, Winners Chapel, all these are Bible Believing Church. So that means that you're open up to all Bible Believing Church, right?
Yes, of course, yeah. All these Bible Believing Church. Like I've been to Winners Chapel, I know. Pentecostal. I see the doctrines they are establishing. I like them. I like them more. Because according to the Bible, what I have, the little knowledge I have, that is how we should live our life. So these people, I'm ready to work with them. I'm ready to work with them.
Okay. So in case a mission like Calvary Chapel all the way from United States may want to come in so that they will work with you and you work with them for the glory of God. We are in this church would be named Calvary Chapel. Will you agree to that?
Well, that is what I have said earlier. The church we have discussed, MCA, that they want to take over. We have given them a promise. Now to give another promise here, Calvary, come and take over, it will be contradicting. But this is just a starting church. This church can give back to 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 churches. We are planning to build more churches in the town here. The town is big. We can plant another church elsewhere. We build up, we build people there. We can go to another villages. Bigger villages are here. Even the chiefdom headquarters is only one church, Mongo Bendugu. So there is a possibility to go to the chiefdom headquarters to plant a church there. So if they want to come, this is MCA. Now, but we can work with churches and plant more churches. Because all we want to see churches in all the areas. All the villages. So there are big places. There are more space again in the town to build churches again. But we don't want to contradict ourselves. You know, they say your word should be your word. You should stand by your word. You know, if we tell MCA now, no, this church does not belong to you, how are they will think something about us? So, yeah, that is all. If that should be happening, the information should be renewed. That information should be renewed. And should be reconciled with them. We should reconcile it with them. Yeah.